Desmond, KOTP TV. We're getting nostalgic today, people. We're getting nostalgic. Let's go. This one's Britney. Charlie must have been the front man because they keep putting him central. Like, he's the king and the other two are his pawns, innit? Let's go. Yo, Levi Plasma and the Lurgy says, remind me of the days Beyblades were popular. You get a thumbs up from me. Yes, you get a thumbs up from me. I had bare Beyblades. I didn't even play with them. I just liked having them. I didn't buy my parents. They come on now. Who's got the best fit on the front cover? Look at Charlie's trousers. This is a song for Britney Spears. Britney Spears was massive at the time this was released. This was part of 2002. Then Britney Spears came out a bit earlier. Britney, was Britney out as early as 99? Or was it like the turn of 2000 when Britney Spears started putting out music? Or Britney Spears' machine started putting out music and utilising her as the front person? I don't believe anybody as young as like these stars. I don't think they make their own decisions as to what's going on or where they're going or who they're getting put in front of. Unfortunately, I think there's a horrific story when it comes to, you know, this pop music when it comes to the young ones. Just say, let me taste you. Dude, who are they trying to sort of... Do you know in like boy bands, they've got like the different members of the bands that represent an appeal to different markets? We got the punk rocker here, the edgy punk rock dude. Look at him with his arms crossed, looking a little bit moody, looking a little bit mischievous. We got Charlie, who I think, Charlie's the art frob of the band. Who's this other dude? He gets a bum deal, I think. I don't think he's got the character the other two have. The other two come across as a little bit more mature. The punk rock guy, not through him, but through the decisions he's making, such as the dying of, well, I guess they've all got dyed hair, haven't they? What's this dude representing? Because this is a machine. This has been built to last. This has been built to appeal to a mass amount of people. So I want to know who this dude is and what the idea is behind his identity and aesthetic. I mean, let's be real, he's probably just a kid of some really rich person who's linked in with the industry and just like get my boy in a band, you know what I mean? Let's be fair. Hey,
I'll become a slave for you. You drive me crazy. You know that I
This is a dead tune. This isn't a good tune at all. Let us down on this one. This is a terrible song. I'm sorry, this one's really bad. Bruh, we got the credits, Producer, Steve Robson. Why is he known as producer unknown other? Why have you thrown unknown in there? What's he getting up to? Steve Robson, producer, and additional producer, John McLaughlin. Studio personnel and mixer, Tom Elmhurst. Programmer? Size up. What do you mean by programmer? What's a programmer? Unknown and other busted. Vocalist, Charlie Simpson. Shout out to my man, Charlie. Yeah, respect to Charlie. Charlie's the coolest dude, man. As far as the band goes, Charlie's pimping the other two. Bass and vocals, Matty J. Shout out to Matty. Simon Ingerfield on the drums. James Bourne on the guitar. Paul Gendler on the vocals. Vocalist Matt Willis. Matt Willis is the punk rock dude, innit? And I think Matty J might be the bassist and the other guy we were discussing. Shout out to Bourne, Robson and McLaughlin. They're the lyricists. Busted don't write their own songs. They do not write their own songs. Oh, that was Britney. That wasn't a great tune. Didn't like that much. I've heard a bit corny. Love song to Britney Spears, bruh. I think Britney was a bit out of Busted's league, to be honest. Britney, super mega huge star. Britney broke America, didn't she? Britney was American, right?